Hello everyone, I welcome you back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to share with you a review of Glen Egg Boiler. With the review, firstly I'll discuss what is the need of egg boiler when egg can be boiled directly in a pan on gas stove. Plus, I'll be also demonstrating how to use this Glen Egg Boiler and I'll be giving you a true review. So stay tuned till the end of the video. But if you are someone who hasn't subscribed to my channel yet, please consider subscribing it. Now I'll discuss why I bought this egg boiler. Eggs are the primary source of protein in our diet. We eat it daily. And when we eat an omelette, the protein is denatured, so there is no use of eating omelette as a protein source. Although I like it personally, I found it the most tastiest form of having an egg, but it is not as healthy as a boiled egg. Now, we can boil the egg on the pan itself, no issues with it. But whenever we overcook an egg, the protein in the egg gets denatured and it is not good to eat denatured protein as it will not be easily absorbed by the body. There is no use of having it. And whenever we underdo an egg, that means we boil it a little less, there is a chance that we may get ill or we may get food poisoning. So there is no point underdoing the egg. And it was getting very difficult to find the exact time of how an egg boils, because it depends upon a lot of things, the vessel you are taking, the amount of water you are taking. So I was always getting eggs which are overdone. So what I was having was that even after trying it for so many times, I was always overdoing my egg and the egg white portion was also a bit hard. So I decided that we should get perfectly done eggs. That is the reason I invested in egg boiler. Secondly, my mother-in-law is vegetarian. Although we had a different pan for boiling the egg, but the same gas stove was there. So we always used to have that guilt feeling. So we decided that we separate the egg boiling part and we keep it out of the kitchen. And the third reason for buying an egg boiler with a poaching tray was that I love poached eggs. I have eaten it once in a restaurant, but after trying it so many times at home, I didn't get the perfect poached egg. Plus, doing poaching at home is very messy. You need a water pan into which you will break the egg, then the egg will get cooked and you will just remove it. So it was getting a bit messy. So we decided to buy an egg boiler with a poaching tray. That is the reason I invested in this. So now let's quickly see the true review of this egg boiler. This is how the egg boiler looks like. It is quite beautiful in design, small in size. I love the color combination, metallic silver with basic black. And the one thing which I like the most about it is its shape. It is square shape. It sits very well on your countertop. It takes a very less space and goes well with the modular design. And now we are going to see what is there inside this egg boiler, what do we get with it. So when we remove the top hard plastic cover, which is this, the first thing which we found was the poaching tray. This is a poaching tray and has four compartments, basically to poach four eggs at the same time. And then the plate which we are seeing in the video is the boiling tray, which we can place eight eggs. They are distinctly placed so that the eggs don't get break. And then this is the main element of the body. Basically, it is the heating element in which we are going to pour water, and the water will get steamed out and the eggs will get boiled. With this, we will also get the measuring cup, because it depends upon the amount of water we are putting into this device, because of which there will be different stages of eggs that will be done. And with this, we also get an instruction manual. This is the basic user guide in which they will tell you what are the things which you are getting. And this is important for knowing the amount of water and what kind of egg do you want. For example, if you want a softened egg, then this amount of water needs to be added. And if you want a medium egg, then this much amount of water is needed, and if you want boiled an egg, this much is the amount of water. Similarly for poaching, it is also mentioned. This is the basic user guide, and I will suggest you to keep it along with the egg boiler till you remember the amount of water you need to add for different eggs. Now we are going to firstly boil the eggs. So I'm going to add 85 ml of water, because in my suggestion I like the well done eggs. So I'll be adding 85 ml of water, and after that I'll be placing all the eggs in the egg tray. And one more tip I would like to give you, and the tip is, don't keep the eggs like the way I am doing it. I am doing one thing wrong. I am keeping the tip at the bottom and the base at the top. This should be done in reverse order. The base should be kept at the bottom and tip at the top so that the eggs won't fall off. So I have successfully placed 8 eggs. I was just showing that we can successfully place 8 eggs, but now I will be boiling only 4 eggs, 2 for me and 2 for my husband. And now we are going to just put the tray into this and cover it, and we'll switch on the power so that the eggs get boiled. So whenever you are turning on the power supply, you will get this blue beautiful light, and when the eggs will be done, the boiler will get automatically cut off like you are seeing in the video. Now the eggs are boiling and the hot steam is coming out. We can see the hot steam, and once it is done, then we will let it rest for about 5 to 8 minutes, that is enough. And then after that we'll open the egg boiler. We may keep the eggs in the boiler for about 3-4 hours. They remain fresh, they remain tender, they remain juicy, and there is no nutritional loss also. Now I'll be quickly sharing a tip with you to peel these eggs fast. You just break them and like crush them like I'm doing in the video. Actually my husband is doing that, and when we crush them, then the skin comes off very easily. One advantage with the egg boiler is that it is very easy to peel the eggs which are boiled in the broiler as compared to the eggs which we boil on the gas stove. That is my personal opinion. How many of you find the process of egg boiling, or rather I should say the process of peeling the eggs, difficult? Do let me know in the comment section. And now these eggs are beautifully done. You can see the color of the yolk, which is yellow. That is why I like it. Now let's quickly see how to do poaching in this egg boiler. For poaching, we need a poaching tray. We can poach 4 eggs at a time, as we have 4 compartments in this tray. Actually, there is no need of applying oil, but I was just checking whether the egg will get stick to it. So I am applying oil at the base so that the egg doesn't get stick to the tray itself. Now, after we are done with applying a little bit of oil, we are going to just directly break the egg into that poaching tray, and I will be poaching 2 eggs again, one for me and one for my husband. And now comes the second egg. I am directly putting that into the poaching tray. We can season it. We will season it basically with salt. You can do with salt, black pepper. And the other thing which I will be doing is, I will be seasoning one with the little bit of coriander. I like the coriander flavor. And now we will be adding 120 ml water to the tray, and we put these raw eggs and the poaching tray, and we are going to cover it and let it get cooked. Poaching basically means steaming the egg, and it is kind of boiled egg and omelette, a mixture of it, but it is far much tastier than boiled egg and far too healthier than the omelette. Now we have successfully poached our 2 eggs, but the yellow liquid which you are seeing on the other egg is not the yolk, it is basically the oil. I have applied a bit extra oil. Now you can see this perfectly poached egg in a beautiful square shape, and they almost look like a cake, but a healthier one. And if your kids don't like to eat boiled egg, try this with them. And those people who just love to eat boiled fish, they will also love the flavor of this poached egg. Now I will show you how well it is done. I will be cutting it and be showing it to you. Even the yolk part is perfectly cooked. Do let me know in the comment section. Do you people want to try this poached egg, or you find it tasty? Now we will move on to, is it easy to clean or difficult to clean? It is very easy to clean, but yes, you need to clean the poaching tray like you clean all your utensils, but the heating element should be clean with a tissue or the soft cotton cloth, and it should not have water in it because a little bit of moisture can cause bacterial or fungal growth, which is not a good healthy thing to have it in your appliance. So you just give it a quick dry wipe and that's it, you are done and you can reuse it. And the same way we will be just giving a quick dry to the upper tray also. So my final review is I am far happy buying this product because egg boiling is not a messy process. Now there are no breaked eggs while boiling. So with this I will end the video. This was a true review of Glen egg boiler. And if you like the video, do hit the like button, share the video with your family and friends, and please subscribe to my channel for getting more such videos. I will see you all in my next video. Till then, stay healthy and blessed. Bye bye.